Ridge.
I'm Nate from Design Squad, and this is the South Street Farm. Today I'm doing a little needs assessment for a small engineering project.
Hi, Nate.
Hey, Chris.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, too. Glad to be here.
Yeah, thanks for coming.
No problem.
Chris is the executive director of Groundworks Somerville, the organization that built this farm.
South Street Farm is an urban agriculture space in a busy, dense city.
Small farms like this around the world rely on engineering in lots of different ways.
We harvest all of the food here and carry it around in wheelbarrows. We put it into these carts that we attach to our bikes that deliver the produce all over the city. We collect rainwater so we can water the plants here on the farm.
This was just a paved lot that had nothing to do with a farm.
It was a place to store old debris from construction projects, including all of the granite blocks that you see.
Chris and the groundwork team repurposed the granite blocks that were scattered around the site to use as their planting beds.
But we do have a problem. Our planting beds are built out of large granite blocks, and they're actually being pushed out of place. We would like Nate to come up with a simple engineering solution so we can move these granite blocks back into place where they were originally.
Moving big, heavy, awkward things is a favorite challenge for engineers.
This is gonna be good.
Fulcrum, lever. I'm gonna use a really big 10-foot long 4x4 as a huge lever to lift the granite block into place.
All around the world, there are lifting and moving tasks to be accomplished where heavy lifting equipment may not be affordable or accessible in the first place. Setups like this are great because they can accomplish the task at hand with simple materials that are available everywhere and good old classic human power.
With a lever, I get to trade distance for strength. So at this end, I'll travel really far, but not push very hard. And on the far end, it travels a little bit, but can pull really hard. Now to demonstrate, I just set the long lever right on top of the fulcrum, but in real life, once I start applying forces in some weird directions, it's gonna wanna tilt off. My idea here is to try to make a ball and socket joint so the lever will stay in place on top of the fulcrum, but can still pivot and twist. I'm gonna install this bolt into the top of the fulcrum, and I'm gonna drill a corresponding hole in the lever. This is a special kind of drill bit called a Forstner bit. Say I want the hole that goes in the lever to be bigger than the diameter of that bolt head so they can fit together. I'm actually gonna drill a few holes so I can adjust the amount of leverage I can get. Let's see if this fits okay. Seems all right. It pivots nicely. Down at this end, I will have the most lifting power, but the least amount of travel up and down. Over here, it's the opposite. I'll have the least amount of lifting power compared to the other end, but I will have the most amount of travel. As soon as this thing goes up in the air, it's gonna wanna do this. We don't want that. Not only do I need stability in this direction, so it doesn't tilt sideways this way, I have to go this way too. Just the weight of that 4x4 added a huge amount of stability. I'm just gonna loop this strap around the block and then we'll be ready to try our first lift. I'm gonna pick it up a little bit and I'm hoping that you can scoot a 2x4 or a 4x4 underneath the rock. 1, 2, 3. Wow, that's a heavy block of rock. Look at that progress.
Nice.
I think I'm gonna move the fulcrum position a little bit so I can get more travel. And we need to get it scooted a bit further up. 1, 2, 3. More progress. Another high five. Now, I'm gonna flip the setup around to get more progress on the opposite side. 1, 2, 3. The block we're moving wants to crash into the block next to it. So to get it into place, I'm gonna try going up and over first. We did it. I was actually able to do it just by myself. Ready for one last lift. Nice.
Wow, Nate, this looks absolutely perfect.
Yo, good success.
Yes, great job.